This video is going to be my holiday buyer's guide for cyclists. So use this video to get gift ideas if you're buying for cyclists, or forward this video to someone to give them ideas if you are a cyclist. And let's just be real honest. We don't want dress socks for Christmas. We want cool bike stuff. All right, so let's get into it. Most of the stuff that I show in this video is going to be in the order of least expensive to most expensive. And if you're new to buying cycling gear, it can get expensive. And finally, on a lot of the products that I'm showing, I've already done reviews, and if I have, I'll put the links in the description below. I'll also put some Amazon affiliate links. I'm a huge proponent of buying from your local bike shop, but if that's not feasible, use the Amazon links that I'll put in the description below. First on the list and least expensive, which can also be a good stocking stuffer, is the Timber Bell. This is a bell that uses the bumps on the trail to notify people that you're coming, particularly hikers and cyclists coming the other way. It's very effective. And like I said in the review that I just did of this, it's a really good piece of safety gear, the Timber Bell. And by the way, the Timber Bell is about $25. Another $25 item is the Crank Brothers M19 multi-tool. Comes in a really cool case, especially for mountain bikers. A multi-tool is absolutely invaluable. This is another thing that makes a really good stocking stuffer. Good quality, has all the essential tools that you'll need to do bike repairs on the side of the trail. So that's the Crank Brothers M19 multi-tool, and by the way, has become my favorite multi-tool. Jumping up to an $80 price tag item is the Tifosi Slice glasses. These are hands down my favorite mountain bike glasses that I've used so far. They're photochromic, which means they get darker in the sun. Not only good for mountain biking, but they're also good for road cyclists, gravel riding. But these are the Slice. What I really like about these is there's no bridge, and so there's a seamless transition between the glasses and looking above them. And they also come with a nice little case and a soft cloth that doubles as a little bag and for wiping off the lenses. Now for $90, the Osprey Cerro Hip Pack. If you're buying for someone who already has a backpack style hydration pack, you may want to get them a hip pack to try it, because these are great for shorter rides. They get the weight off your back. This has a hydration bladder. It also has a lot of storage for a hip pack with little compartments. Listen, I'd love to get this for Christmas. Everything that I'm showing you, I'd love to get for Christmas. And I've been riding for a really long time. So that's the Osprey Cerro Hip Pack. Now this, by the way, is something that you want to buy for mainly a mountain biker. If someone rides road or gravel, typically don't ride with a hip pack. I've always got to include a helmet in my holiday buyer's guide, and this is the Giro Artex MIPS. This helmet is designed for road cyclists, gravel cyclists, and cross-country mountain bikers, or maybe even trail riders. One thing that I like about this helmet is that it has a visor. I like riding with a visor on gravel because it keeps the sun off my face. But what I like about this is how easy the visor comes off. That's just so easy, and it's never fallen off. So that's the Giro Artex MIPS. Listen, I've strapped a lot of skid lids to this noggin, and this is probably one of the most comfortable helmets that I've used. It doesn't fall down in front of my eyes. It's one of those helmets that you put on and you just don't know it's there. And it has MIPS, which means it has really good protection should you need it. So that's the Giro Artex MIPS, $140. Now, jumping up quite a bit in price is a $200 item. These are the best trail riding mountain bike shoes I've ever used. Now, if you're buying for a road cyclist, this doesn't apply. Cross-country mountain biking, maybe, but this is more for trail and enduro. These are the 510 Kestrel Pros. And by the way, 510 is now owned by Adidas. Again, super comfortable shoe. What I like about this is the sole is stiff. These style of SPD shoes, and this is for if you're buying for someone who uses clipless pedals, which you lock your shoe into. I like the stiffness of the sole. I've tried some of these style of shoes where the sole wasn't stiff and I just gave up on them. But the 510 Kestrel Pros, a really good high performance mountain bike shoe for someone who rides more trail, gravity, enduro type riding. All right, the next item doesn't necessarily apply to cyclists. It's just a super cool product. The best earbuds that I've ever used. the Jaybird Vista 2s. The Jaybird Vista 2s come in a case. There's all kind of really cool features on these. Active noise canceling, super good sound quality. Much better, in my opinion, than Apple earphones. These work with Android, iOS. So again, not necessarily a cycling product, but a product that I think anybody is going to want to get to include a cyclist. That's the Jaybird Vista 2s. Not cheap, $200, but again, a really good, high quality, great sounding earbud that's waterproof. So these things, by the way, are completely waterproof. You can drop them in water. Now I'm going to show you three Garmin GPS computers, and I'll describe which situation these work best for. First of all, the Garmin Vivo Active 4. I think I've included these in a buyer's guide before, but this is a smartwatch that works on Android and iOS. This is really great for tracking your rides, especially if you're the type of person that does multi-sports. So maybe you do running, hiking, kayaking, biking. This you can use for all of those. So it's not just a bike-specific computer. And by the way, the Garmin Vivo Active 4 is $240. Moving up to a much more expensive item, this is the Garmin Edge 830. This is a cycling computer that does so much. I could take an hour to talk about all the features, tracking, GPS, hooking it up to all kinds of sensors. But listen, if you're buying for someone who's a mountain biker and they don't have a good bike computer, the Garmin Edge 830 is one of the best in the business. And this works on road bikes too, by the way. I'm going to show you one that's better for road, but especially for someone who mountain bikes and road bikes, the Garmin Edge 830 is a phenomenal bike computer. And this one retails for about $400. Now, if you're buying for someone who mainly rides road bikes or gravel bikes, I would recommend the Garmin Edge 1030 Plus. And I have this in a little rubber cover. Let me take it out so you can see it. So that is the Garmin Edge 1030 Plus. This one retails for about $600. The advantage over the 830 is it just has a bigger screen. This to me is a little bit too big for mountain biking. It kind of moves around too much on the handlebars, which is why I like the smaller, lighter 830 for mountain biking. Again, for someone who rides road and gravel, the Garmin Edge 1030 Plus. All right, now for one of the coolest gift ideas, I think, on this whole buyer's guide. And this is the GoPro Hero 10. So if you want to buy an action camera for a cyclist, this thing is phenomenal. I've gone through so many GoPros over the years, and this is the best one today. Obviously, it's the latest and greatest, but this one does not crash all the time like some of my other GoPros. The image stabilization is awesome. It's not cheap. It's about $500, but for an action cam that can double as just a video camera that you just take places, that's super small, you can throw it in your pocket. So not just good for cyclists, obviously. Anybody who needs a small action camera, the GoPro Hero 10 gets my highest recommendation. And the final two items are great if you want to buy for someone who doesn't want to get fat, lazy, and grumpy over the winter time. Yes, I'm talking about indoor trainers. So for these, we're going to have to get up because I'm not going to pick this thing up because it's like super heavy. So this is the $1,200 Wahoo Kicker Smart Trainer. This is a trainer that you can hook a bike up to. I don't have time to go into the benefits of smart trainers, but they're for riding indoors. It will wirelessly connect to your computer, your phone, your iPad. There's all kinds of apps you can use with this, but for someone who wants to train through the winter, this is one of the best smart trainers you can buy right now. Now, if someone you're buying for already has a Wahoo Kicker smart trainer and they don't have the Wahoo Kicker Climb, this makes a great gift idea. This lifts the front end of the bike up or down, depending on if you're going up or down a hill. So it makes riding indoors feel a little bit more realistic. This is $600. I don't think it works with smart trainers that are not a Wahoo smart trainer. So again, if someone already has the Wahoo Kicker Climb, this accessory makes a great gift idea. So that is this year's holiday buyer's guide. Hopefully this video will help you buy something for a cyclist that they'll really like this year. If you have any questions or comments, drop those below and I'll try to get to them. Thanks for watching.